Okay, I can remember the day like it was yesterday. It was 1968, and I think it was December 8th. And anyway, it was a Tuesday night, and there was this guy that I knew. His name was Dad, and he was known by the rest of the people in the Euclid community as Burnball Ernie Hall. Well, Burnball, or Dad as I affectionately called him, took me and some of my brothers and sisters up to the Euclid Public Library like he did every Tuesday night. And that particular night, while my brothers and sisters all went over to the children's section of the Euclid Public Library, I found myself sneaking over into the adult section. And in doing so, there was this big book, and on the front cover of the book was just the word Australia. And I was all of 5 years old. I didn't know what Australia was. And I opened the book, and my God, it looked like something I had never seen before, could never have imagined. There were kangaroos, there were koalas, and then there was this place called the Great Barrier Reef. And the pictures of the Great Barrier Reef were just incredible, just beautiful, all these beautiful fish. And right then and there I knew, before I leave this earth, that's someplace that I want to go, is the Great Barrier Reef. Well, this boat that's right behind me, called the Poseidon, here in Port Douglas, I'm going to be getting on it here momentarily and taking a trip out to the Great Barrier Reef, where we're going to do 3 different locations of diving and snorkeling. I signed up for an introductory diving course, so it'll be my first time with an oxygen tank on the back of my on my back. And I'm excited. I'm like a little kid, you know, on Christmas morning waiting to open up my gifts. I am going to go and dive the Great Barrier Reef in Australia. And I'm going to bring you along in the process. So let's go get wet. Okay, so we're on our way out to the Great Barrier Reef, and they spent some time talking to us about what we're going to see out there and some of the precautions and all that good kind of stuff. The crew on the Poseidon is really a fantastic crew. I'm really feeling comfortable and excited about the day. They split us into 3 groups. They split us into a group that's going to do only snorkeling. They split us into another group that's going to be actually certified divers. And then I'm in the group of introductory divers. So we had to fill out the obligatory medical release and, medical history and waiver, release rate waivers, all that kind of stuff. But the weather is nice. The ocean, it's very, very calm. It's, they say 15 to 20 knots. I'm not a sailor, so I don't know, if that's rough or not. But I did take some pill for motion sickness, and there's not a lot of motion going on right now, so I'm going to get back into the class here and learn how to dive.
Cool. Now the strap, where does the strap belong? Now the strap belongs on the back part of your head. There. Yeah. Now you pull a little bit on the sides there. Yeah. And you have it just above your lips. That is actually the perfect look. All right. Looks okay. What doesn't look okay is this one. The first one. I'm blowing too. Right, yeah. After about 5 minutes, you start to get a problem with your ears. We have a special name for this type of mask. We call this a Prince Charles hook, yeah? Right, ears are falling over to the front of the wall. Ouch, yeah, 5 minutes. And then you start to relieve yourself. You're, woohoo! This is much better, yeah? And about 3 seconds later, what's going on? Why is it leaking all the time? I have no idea why, yeah? Right. The reason why is because the strap was below your ears and your mask was going to go down. Okay? Underwater, leave it please to the instructors. Yeah? So leave it to us. We will take care of your buoyancy underwater. Because if you're a little too excited, they're like, hey, it says something about inflating. Well, let's try that. Yeah, whoosh, there you go. You're too fast, all right? Not a very good idea. So please leave it to us. Yeah? So we do that underwater. However, when you're at the surface, now everybody would like to stay at the surface, you have a weight belt on, you're pretty heavy there. So if you would like to stay there nicely at the surface, inflate your BSD. And you're nicely floating out there, yeah?
Okay. So they're giving some little class up here on the top deck.
I will try to explain how this came to be. All right. Now, through the course of history, we've had several different ice ages. The most important of which was about 20,000 years ago. And what happens? in an ice age is that the water gets sucked up into the ice caps, and so this whole area becomes very exposed. The continental shelf that we're sitting in right here looks completely different 20,000 years ago. There wasn't all this water. In fact, parts of it were mountain ranges, bushlands,
right,
floodplains. Parts of it were still connected to the Daintree rainforest, right? Very different to how it looks now. Now, when the ice age hit and all the water when the ice age finished and all the water started to slowly come back over the continental plains here, what happened was you had all this very, very shallow flood water coming in. It was very clear, not a lot of sediment, and it didn't have a lot of nutrients. Now, these factors are pivotal for coral survival, okay? So you had these pioneer species of corals, these really tough scouts, and they were sent out across this continental shelf in these shallow waterways to seek utopia. Yeah, they needed to find the happy place. Now, corals, they're a bit fussy. They need something hard to attach to start growing. They can't just grow in sand. Not so good. It's really hard.
Just an incredible experience. And they've got all types of nice refreshments for us as well. You got some melon and oranges and muffins and all the works, and really a nice nice day here on the Poseidon.
Okay, this is it, diving the Great Barrier Reef. Can you believe it? They've got us all situated in our gear here. I got my weights on, and we're just moments away from going down under the water. The water here is beautiful, actually gorgeous, and I'm looking forward to getting wet.
Well, will you look at me diving the Great Barrier Reef in Australia? Take this off my bucket list. You can see the wonderment in my eyes as I wave to Kane, who was videotaping me. And there's Kane there. When he takes his hand and makes that symbol, that means everything is okay. He's asking if everything's okay. So they taught you several symbols as you were diving, and as we were going down through this, Kane would see different things of interest, and he would use this little pointer, such as you'll see him do here, to point out some fish. And the quality of the visibility wasn't the best, but nonetheless, these are some videos that I'll definitely cherish the rest of my life. As we were swimming through, you would see all types of different fish, and there is a rather large fish right there, two of them actually. But so when we started the day, they broke us into groups, and I was in the introductory diving group. And they went through the courses, as you saw, and the gentleman that was teaching us originally, he was he's from Holland, actually. But anyway, Kane is from New Zealand. He's from the same area that I was staying, over off of Auckland, in the Henderson area. So the way that it worked out was they put us into these groups, and in doing so, it turned out that on the first dive, the dive you're watching here is actually the second dive, but on the first dive, it was just Kane and I and one other young man. And the young man opted not to go on the second dive. So fortunately for me, it was just Kane and I. And I think that Kane sensed that I felt pretty comfortable diving. And we had a really nice time. We were down there for the better part of 30 minutes. And I didn't know what to expect. There I am, waving, you know, to the cameras, and you'll see me do the little thumbs up, but then I got to do the little symbol there that means everything's okay, as Kane holds the camera there. But we were down for about 30 minutes, and I didn't know what to expect, but it was actually very, very comfortable breathing underwater, and definitely something that I would love to do again. The water was just absolutely beautiful, as I give the okay symbol again. But again, the visibility wasn't the best, but you know, how often you get to dive the Great Barrier Reef in Australia. So it was just start to finish. I paid an extra $60 to do the introductory dive, And then, much to my surprise, to do an additional dive, it was $40. So how could I say no? These little things were, I don't know what they were, just hanging on the side of the rocks. But sea urchins or something like that, they would open and close. There's another nice view. It just seemed around every corner you would see different types of fish, and they don't mind you swimming around. There's another big fish. Toward the end of the dive, I didn't get it on film, there was a massive fish that you could just swim alongside and actually pet him. But this was the second dive, and it just left me speechless. I was just underneath there, just amazed. Here he is pointing out something, some type of a seaweed or something, and when he would touch it, it would kind of retract. But anyway, so this is nearing the end of the second dive, and we were these are some fish. I think these are poisonous fish, if I'm not mistaken, that he was pointing out. But anyway, Kane, you know, if you ever watch this, thank you very much, man. You gave me a memory that I'll cherish for the rest of my life.
All right, so you know what? I got to tell you, it was absolutely incredible. My first diving experience ever, and what a place to do it, the Great Barrier Reef. So I signed up for one dive. We're stopping at three locations, and you know, they asked me if I was going to dive again, and the answer was hell yes. What an experience that is. So I'm looking forward to diving again, and on the next dive I'll be able to take my underwater GoPro and bring you for the experience as well. Okay, so you can see everybody here is getting situated after spending some time under the water, and quite an experience, I gotta say, you know? Really, really incredible. What a wonderful experience. It makes me want to take up diving. I know my friend Larry back in Ventura, California, he's been wanting me to dive for quite a while. And I think it's definitely something that I'm going to want to do. And this was my instructor right here. This was Kane. Hey, Kane. So how'd I do for a first dive, all right?
Yeah, not bad, mate. Not bad.
Not bad, mate, huh?
Good, buddy. Good.
Hey, so I'm going to go down again with you on the next dive. I was curious as we were swimming around down there. How many times have you done this? Countless. Do you ever see things that you haven't seen before?
Oh, every day.
Every day, huh?
Every day.
All right. Well, sounds good. I'm looking forward to the next dive.
Yeah, me too, buddy.
All right. Okay, so as I walk around here, you can just see everybody's really excited about having just dove the... Go Seahawks! This is a gentleman that's from Seattle. How'd you like it?
It was wonderful. Beautiful.
Was that your first experience?
First ever. And you?
Incredible. Yeah, my first experience as well. You going to do a second dive?
We're just going to snorkel now.
Oh, you're going to snorkel, huh? All right. So I'm going to find some fruit. They're passing some fruit around here. And really a beautiful day on the Great Barrier Reef. The weather is just fantastic. And you can see that the water is just really ideal for this type of a day here out on the Great Barrier Reef. Okay, much to both my surprise and delight, I didn't know it, but they actually serve lunch included with the diving and snorkeling experience. So on the lunch menu today, looks like they've got fresh rolls, and they've got, what else do they have? Salad and all types of salad, potato, pasta salad. They have tandoori chicken and ham and roast beef. And then down on the end, it looks like they've got some really nice prawns and all the fixings here for a wonderful lunch. So we finished two of our three dives. We got one more dive to go, and we'll do our last dive on a full belly. The staff here on the Poseidon is really fantastic. Just from the time you get on,
Yeah, they are.
So they're I was just telling one of the individuals that was taking me down, what a job that they've got, you know, to go taking people down on the Great Barrier Reef. So I'm going to dig in and have some lunch here on the Poseidon before doing my final dive.
Okay, with lunch in our bellies, we've arrived at the final stop here, and it looks gorgeous. You can actually see that's the captain up there with the orange vest on. And if I come over here, you can actually see the reef. So, look at that. Give you a nice view. I guess it's a low tide right now, so you can see. There is the zoom in a little bit. So there is the there's the reef, and we're gonna go out and do some nice snorkeling. Pool is open, the captain is saying. Okay, so you can see everybody getting into the water here and handing off. One of the tour members there in the front, she's going to do a little tour, snorkeling tour for the folks. So it looks like a great spot to dive, actually. I'm looking forward to getting out there. Actually, I'm going to be snorkeling on this this excursion. What a great experience this has been for me.
All right, so, you know, you can take snorkeling off my bucket list on the Great Barrier Reef. What an experience. And, you know, if you come to Australia and you're going to do the Great Barrier Reef, you got to use Poseidon. Start to finish, what a great outfit this is. Somebody recommended Poseidon to me to, you know, experience the Great Barrier Reef, and I gotta tell you, really, really satisfied. So if you come to Australia, make sure you go to Port Douglas, look up Poseidon, and let them show you a great day on the Great Barrier Reef. See you later.
Okay, so we're pulling back into Port Douglas, and as we do so, you can see some beautiful homes up on the hill there. Those are definitely some nice waterfront property here in Port Douglas, Australia. So you can hear everybody clapping behind me, indicating that their day was as wonderful as mine. So we're going to pull into the harbor here. You can see the beautiful palm trees. What a wonderful day, what a fantastic experience for me. Definitely something that I'll remember for the rest of my life. And I hope those of you watching this video enjoyed it as well. So, absolutely, if you come down to Port Douglas, if you come to Australia to do the Great Barrier Reef, you definitely want to come to Port Douglas. Port Douglas is the closest out to the reef. It takes about a little bit over an hour. Other places that you might go see the reef from, ports, might take 2-3 hours to get out to the reef. So, anyway, as we pull into the harbor here in Port Douglas, I'll say goodbye from another day down under.